Hello everyone, welcome to this 2D animation tutorial. In this video, you learn how to create a cool 2D dust explosion animation, just like this one, which you could use as a special effect in your 2D game project. This is a very simple tutorial that fits all levels, and you really don't have to be a professional artist to create this effect on your own. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and create some explosions. Let's open Photoshop and create a new document. Let's color the background dark gray, so that it will be easier to see our dust explosion. Good! Now, let's create a new layer above the background and select a light gray color. Then, let's switch to the brush tool and make sure that we're using the hard round brush. I'm making the brush size a bit bigger and starting with some dots around the center. It already looks like a small cloud of dust, and to make this cloud shape look a bit more random, I'm going to use some different brush sizes. Okay, this should be fine. I'm switching to Move tool and making sure the dust cloud is positioned exactly in the center of the layer. Then I'm creating a new layer on top of that, switching to Brush tool again, and starting to paint the dots near the edges of the smaller cloud. Again, I'm trying to randomize the shape by using different sizes of the brush. Switching the layer 2 off, so that we can see our new cloud better. This cloud should be a bit bigger than the previous one, and it's going to have a hole in the center, like a donut. It doesn't have to be symmetrical, so feel free to experiment with the brush sizes. Alright, at the moment, this dust effect looks flat. So, let's make it more interesting by adding some highlights. I'm choosing the gray color, but it should be a bit lighter than the one we've used before. Again, using the hard round brush, I'm painting some random dots on top of our donut. Try to stay inside the shape and use different brush sizes. By the way, the dots can overlap, and it will make our highlights look even better. Okay, this should be enough. Let's create a new layer and switch to the gray color we used for the dust cloud shape. I'm making the brush size a bit bigger and painting 5 dots around our donut, like that. Then I'm using an even bigger brush to paint some overlapping circles. On this frame, our dust cloud splits into multiple parts, so no need to connect between them. Make sure you randomize the shapes so that they look more natural. Good! When you finish painting the shapes, switch to the lighter gray and start painting some highlights, like we did before. Creating some overlapping circles again. Alright, once we're done, we're going to create another layer. On this frame, our dust clouds split into even smaller parts and fly farther away from one another. So, I'm switching to the darker gray, making the brush size just a little bit bigger than I've used for the highlights, and starting to paint the dots near our dust clouds, this time farther away from the center of the layer. Good! I'm adding more overlapping dots to make them look like tiny clouds. You can make each cloud look different, and you don't have to keep them all the same size. The more random they look, the better. I'm also adding some smaller particles here. This will make our dust explosion look richer. Okay. I think that's enough. Let's go ahead and add the highlights. You don't have to put a highlight on each and every particle. I'm going to skip some of the smaller ones. Alright, creating a new layer again. On this frame, our dust clouds really start to dissipate, so we need to make them even smaller and a bit farther away from the center than before. Again, I'm switching to the darker gray and painting a few small circles near each cloud. Then, I'm adding a number of tiny particles between the dots and adding more overlapping circles. Here we go. Then, once again, let's add the highlights here and there. Great! Now, let's add another layer, and on this frame, we just have the traces of our tiny dust clouds. I'm going to use the light gray that we've used for the highlights, painting just a few dots where the dust clouds were. Switching to the smaller brush and adding more tiny particles. Looks pretty good! Let's change the opacity of this layer. It should be about 50%. and the opacity of the previous layer should be about 75-80%. Perfect! I'm adding the last layer and it should be just an empty frame. Let's go ahead and turn on all of our layers and then click on Window, Timeline. This will open a timeline here below. And now let's click Create Frame Animation button. Good! Now let's click the small menu icon and select the Make Frames from Layers option. Each layer has become a frame of the animation. Let's delete the first frame, as it is just the background, and then select all the frames and turn on the layer 1. Now the explosion should be seen really great. Let's hit play to see how it looks. Awesome! The dust explosion effect looks really nice. You can make the adjustments if you like, add more particles or play with the opacity of the frames number 5 and 6. I'm happy with how the animation looks right now, so I'll just keep it as is. That brings us to the end of this tutorial. If you liked it and learned something new, please give this video a thumbs up and share it with friends. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to see more of our tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and until the next one!